friends, and welcome to the happiness fitness class that I am running. This is my first time, so thank you for bearing with me as I work through the technical difficulties. I'm just running the whole show, and so just to give an introduction. So I have compiled some information, and hopefully you will enjoy what we've got going on here. So who am I? You can find me on the internet, of course, through Wise Stamp. My post-traumatic growth. I also have a Facebook group, My Post-Traumatic Growth, and a Facebook page, Post-Traumatic Growth, as well as I'm on Twitter and Eventbrite, you can look me up there, and email. So, and what is this about? So this is a happiness workshop and or a happiness presentation, and the latest theme that I'm working off of is that we are actual, like, real estate. We are our most valuable land, and of course the most valuable is the 4 inches between our ears. And so one of the aspects of lifestyle design, because what I'm here to do is help people shape their, like, redesign their lifestyle, and if another word for it is reality architecture. So you have architecture in order to build a building, your house, and you also have, you can, you know, there's that term castles in the air, and so I'm here to help you with your reality architecture. So a little bit of housekeeping. Please pardon the technical glitches as I am juggling running the cameras, running the computer, and just figuring all of this out myself here. Also just like presenting this new information. And so there's going to be a quiz, and it's about it's going to be an easy quiz, and I just invite you, if you have a journal, a diary, if you can, and if you don't have any of those at hand, if you can grab a piece of paper and a pen that you like to write on, have a surface that's comfortable to write with, and worst comes to worst, if you only have a post-it, that's a good thing to snag right now. So you got that. So yeah, just pardon any kind of technical glitches that occur, and I want to start off with asking, like, how are you feeling right now? So just do a little inventory. You know, are you feeling a little tense? Are you feeling numb? Do you not feel anything right now? And just make a note of it. And one of the things that's, like, I am guilty of this too. I will listen to an audiobook or watch a video, and I won't do the thing that the folks are suggesting. And I'm just encouraging you for just a few seconds, just bear with me, try it out. So hopefully you've kind of done just a little check-in with yourself. And then, I want to encourage you to consider, what is a goal that you have? And just go with the first thing that comes to mind. It can be as minor as decluttering the living room, or it could be getting a new hairstyle, or it can be traveling to the Grand Canyon. So now that you have just the first idea that comes to your mind, I want you to think of a symbol. Like, what does it represent? What's a simple symbol that gold represents to you? So it could be a smiley face, it could be a heart face, heart shape of a heart, star, whatever. Just the first symbol that comes to your mind. I want you to write that down. And just write what the goal is off to the side. And the symbol is really important. Our subconscious mind kind of interprets and anchors to symbols, whereas words and letters are more like cerebral. And so I'm just encouraging you to let's engage with our deeper parts. So why me? Who am I? And what I am doing is I have a history of doing content creation, and this picture here is a company I worked at and was a public utility company, and they had me do a type of market research, which was me looking at different websites, newspapers, and online databases referring to the utility industry. And I would summarize what was the latest news of the week for the public utility industry. And so I just researched data and archived it in a database and made it accessible for others to refer to. And I did that before then, and I continue to do so. And my focus is more about health these days. And so you might be asking, well, am I in the right place? And do you feel like you're overwhelmed in general? Do you feel like you have a huge to-do list? Are you having a hard time falling asleep at night or staying asleep? Do you wake unrested? Is your health, could your health be better? Well, you are in the right place. And what I'm observing is people's superpower a lot now, the average person, is just being able to show up. And that is a lot. And the goal of this presentation is to encourage you to show up for yourself more, to show up for what's important to you. And a little bit more about me. I have facilitated various workshops, particularly on life plan coaching, speaking circles, like public speaking practice, and job search coaching, resume writing. And so some of the feedback I got was that I'm outstanding, supportive, I made a big difference, I was inspiring. And I have a lot of credentials. I have certification in feng shui, iridology, body work, aura chakra past life readings. And I currently am the host of the functional forum here. We talk about health topics once a month at the public library. And also, I was one of the first 200 students of Chris Presser's Adapt Academy, of his beta test. So in next month, every month we do a functional forum at the library. And so what is the purpose of doing this brainstorming that we're doing? What's the value of just taking this time? And what this time is an investment in your well-being. And the bottom line of truth on that is for cancer patients, the cost, the value they provide is half of $1 million. So it's $0.5 million that the medical industry, big pharma, and insurance companies gain from people being sick with cancer. And it is $3 million value that autistic children make the medical industry for having autism. The cost of disease is a chronic illness, is expensive. And not only, it's expensive, like we are paying the price, and the insurance industry is a cost plus, like they are, it's a growth industry, as is medicine, as is big pharma. They want to grow, and the only way they can grow is when people are sick. And so once again, this comes back to you are real estate for you. You are your own landscape. You are your own real estate. And you get to determine what happens to that real estate best to your ability. And other people see this real estate as value. And they see sick, you being sick is more valuable than being healthy, of course. And in my mission is that you get to have your healthy real estate. And so the point of this is to be realistic, help you think about valuable actions that are solution oriented, and provide easy, immediate results, and replace people pleasing with representing your own interests. And one last thing, and the thing is, so this quote, denial and inactivity prepare people well for the roles of victim and corpse. So the way you've done things before, perhaps, might be, well, it's just too much trouble, we don't want to rock the boat, people won't like it if I want things different. And
John Leech says, denial and inactivity prepare people well for the roles of victim and corpse. And there is a lot of
distress that people are under, a lot of strain just from what's going on politically, interpersonally, in families, sociologically. There's just like kind of chaos going on. And people are more stressed possibly than any time in contemporary recorded history. And I think that there's options, there's alternatives to just accepting things as they are. And there's this website, excuse me, called Thrive, and it's Thrive, Thrive, and they talk about adding certain things into your life and removing certain things into our lives. And so, like I said, a lot of people have a to-do list a mile long. And if you're watching this, you probably are doing some things that are constructive. So you probably can check off some of the items on this list as things that you have effectively included into your life, and things that you've effectively eliminated into your life. So things to add is pleasure. If you've watched my other two shows on MCAT, you'll see that I talk about the parasympathetic system. So we have what's called an autonomic nervous system, and so we have the parasympathetic system. So the sympathetic is kind of a counterintuitive name. It is more of our stress and strain response. And the parasympathetic nervous system is about rest and digest. It's our peaceful system. So from what all of the research that I'm doing so far is, illness really has a lot to do with our stress response and being in a heightened state of chronic stress. You can be eating organic and breathing, excuse me, fresh air. And if you are under a lot of stress and a lot of negative talk, like, your cells are not going to release the toxins that it holds. And it just seems like it's a, when it's in like self-destruct mode, if we succumb and surrender to a chronic stress mode. So it's a long explanation for adding more pleasure into your life. And I understand we are a culture of stress. Stress is kind of like, it kind of gives us, it's our excuse for existing in this culture. And so what I'm saying is that we need to grant that we get to be alive. We don't have to be super mom or super dad or super kid. And I know that's a whole other like 30-year lifelong thing to like accept one as you know, as deserving to exist for no good reason. The thing is, if we are allowing ourselves to be stressed out because it's what society wants us to be. Society wants us to be busy and busy and busier. There's a price that we pay in terms of chronic illness, or being unable to conceive, or dying early. So activating that parasympathetic stress response in a way, like, so parasympathetic is our rest and digest. So we want to activate our peaceful response. And like help the stress response to stand down. And one of the, and so there's a lot of things that cause us stress. It can be sound pollution, like really annoying jackhammer going on and car traffic or people screaming. So sound pollution is one aspect of stress. Air pollution, if you live off the on-ramp and have to smell like lead, you know, gas all the time, of course emotional stress and financial stress. And another big stress is lack of connection, lack of sense of community. So those are some aspects of stress. So if you don't have enough, let's say, social contact with people, make small, safe, realistic attempts to have more connection with people. If there's a lot of chronic noise going on, maybe see if you can get some earplugs or create some sort of sound barrier. Just make some adjustments. If your house is really noisy, maybe when people are walking, maybe put carpeting on the floor, if you can afford to do that. Do it safely, of course. So we want to activate our rest and digest and remove as many stressful triggers as possible. And for those who are into hormesis, into, well, we need some stress in order to keep healthy, life is always going to give you some stress. I mean, it, and the thing is, there are some people who are super able to control every last little thing. And so if you're like a super controlling person who doesn't let anything kind of get to them, well, that's a whole other program.
So in terms of the next one, it's described as energy, but it's talking about like sunlight and nature. So we do need to have contact with nature. We need fresh air. To me, being by the river is just so life-giving. There's that topic of earthing, grounding, like taking your shoes off and putting your feet in the grass or on soil, and that's supposed to affect our electromagnetic system. So having more contact with nature is
another really good thing to either have more in your life and maybe give yourself credit. Hey, you do that. You go out to the yard, you take your dog for a walk.
So in terms of
things to remove in this along the lines of energy is electromagnetic frequencies. That's also called electromagnetic interference. So if you, let's say you sleep by, like there's a electrical outlet right by your head at night when you're sleeping. So you wanna make sure your head is not right, is not right next to an electrical outlet. That's pretty toxic. Make sure that your spouse isn't sleeping right next to it, or your child isn't sleeping right next to an electrical outlet. I mean, ideally it would be nice if you could have like several feet distance from that, but at least don't have it by your head. Also, turn your alarm clock away from you so the light isn't shining on you. Sometimes I've used, see-through plastic, so it's super dim, and I set the alarm to like the dim setting, but it's just not dim enough when it's late. Also, I know this is going to be hard for a lot of people, but have your phone outside of your room. I would recommend getting an old school alarm clock and not using your phone for an alarm clock, but if you must use your phone for an alarm clock, have it on the table, like have it in airplane mode and have it on the table as far away from you in your room as possible. And turning off or turning down lights at night. So, when it's like 8 o'clock at night, start turning down the lights. So you get into the mentality of, we're going to go to sleep. And you know about like blue light on your computer, it's activating, and there's information out there that staring at a blue light is causing causing some type of visual problems. So maybe look into getting, like there's Flux, FLUX, which is a type of screen dimming software. There's also those blue blocker light glasses that people are getting. So definitely try to reduce your light exposure after sundown. And there is what's called the lights out protocol when you're going to sleep at night to, reduce the light coming in from street lights and whatnot. So in terms of water, we do want to drink clean water. So if you can get a water filter, that try to get the best water filter that you can. And we need clean water, and so we need to filter out the toxins as best as we can from our drinking water, and in a perfect world, from our bathing water. And of course, food. We want to have the best quality food, and for people on a budget, of which I am one, there's the clean 15 and dirty dozen of fruits and vegetables. So the clean 15, and you can easily look that up, those have fewer pesticides sprayed on them, and the dirty dozen are just out of control. And this list also recommends fasting, and the people who are watching this, who have been dealing with autoimmune trigger, like post-traumatic stress disorder that triggered autoimmune issues, oftentimes our glands are shot due to the chronic stress. So I would say that fasting in the conventional sense may be inadvisable and might kind of create a trigger. And some of the suggestions I'm making can be a doable rewarding fast. So fasting as much as you can from stressful thoughts, fasting from that sympathetic stress response. And I would even say, like, including new things is a fast from doing it the old way. So the old way would be like, I don't care, whatever, I'm just going to do whatever. And so the new way, the new topic would be a fast from doing it the way you've already always done.
And so exercise,
movement practice. So again, for the people who are dealing with post-traumatic stress disorder and autoimmune issues, exercise is, like, in the conventional sense, it's out of the question. Or in my experience, I mean, I can barely have energy to brush my hair sometimes or do housekeeping. And so when I do that, I consider that a movement practice, and I do my physical therapy. And so I would just say, you know, if you're doing your physical therapy, if you're doing kind of the basic foundation of things that keep your living space, you know, functional, not too cluttered, that I would consider a movement practice. And so there's things to, so the what she put as what to avoid is procrastination. And what I've observed is people can be hard on themselves. They don't give themselves credit for what they are doing, even if it's just a little bit. So people are doing a movement practice. They are keeping things tidy. You know, they're showing up. So I would say like procrastination is a whole other workshop in of itself. And what I would say instead of trying to avoid procrastination is recognizing that you are doing like one molecule of a part of something. You know, you are doing a movement practice. Just by watching this video, that is something.
In terms of emotion, we were talking about that, the parasympathetic and stress, sympathetic stress response. So we want to just boost the parasympathetic. We want to boost the rest and digest, because when we rest and digest, we're also detoxing. Like, sleep is when our brain detoxes viruses and heavy metals and toxins. So resting is a great detoxifier. And in terms of, she has something about tests here.
And from what I understand, there's like, you can kind of pull the food and, you know, do I want to drink this chamomile tea? And if you lean towards it, you want to, like, your body is liking the chamomile tea. And then she has to avoid stressful testing. And so, I don't know about you, but I have had some pretty horrible experiences going for an MRI or whatever, where nobody explained to me that I'd be there for a couple hours and that I'd just be really depleted and blah, blah, blah. So I think, like, fruitless testing, where it just, like, takes you several days to recover from this horrible experience where they just have some more statistics for the medical records, I would avoid that.
And so in terms of
the body, pay attention to how you feel. Again, you are your most valuable real estate. You are your real estate, not big pharma, not the medical industry, and not insurance companies. I'm sorry.
And then in terms of supplements, that's up to you to decide. And just keeping on detoxing your environment and your mindset, that is key. So in terms of
happiness, so as I was was talking about in the beginning, it's natural for us to kind of, well, maybe not be natural, but some folks may lack optimism, which is a building block of happiness. And if you've watched my other videos on the MCAT system, there's a quote about from Martin Seligman, who's the grandfather of the positive psychology movement, and it goes something like, you know, if it's never worked before, why should it work now? You know, like, people have a learned helplessness, and so when you have learned helplessness and it's been reinforced by the agents, you know, the supposed agents of the public good, the trusted agents of the public good, it's hard to show up. It's hard to change the direction of the ship. And so I'm just trying to encourage people to give it, just show up, keep on trying. And so in terms of optimism, one of the keys is to be willing, and we need to build upon each step. So I took this happiness training with my feng shui teacher, Nancy Woodruff, and she said that we have to do each step, we have to complete each step before we're invited to do the next step. So this will be, like, I'm going to be doing the next several sessions. I'm going to do referring to each of the foundations to happiness. So this one is about optimism and being hopeful enough to just try one little thing differently. So that is the first. That I would recommend. So with that, we're going to look at your goals again. So this is the quiz, and like I was saying, that our well-being is worth millions of dollars. It's a valuable resource. Our chronic illness is a valuable source of income for the medical industry, the pharmaceutical industry, and the insurance industry. They want it to keep on happening. And it's because it employs a lot of people, and there's a lot of people who would say, well, people need to have jobs. There's more people employed by the cancer industry than have cancer. And they're, you know, and okay, you know, however, some people don't want to get cancer, some people don't want their kids to have autism. People don't want to have diabetes or go blind. And so those people who really want to make some changes in their health, I would like to give some ideas. And with that, also have a positive goal. So rather than just avoiding being ill, what are kind of goals? And so some people, they want to run marathons, or they want to start a fitness class, start attending a dance class, or start yoga, or go horseback riding, or something. So and in terms of your short-term or long-term goals, it can be whatever. It doesn't have to be what I just described. So with that pen and paper or your journal, make a note of what it is that you're wanting to bring more of. It could be more nature, or more quality time with family, or have some quality rest. And again, I want you to think about how that makes you feel, and just like, you know, your senses, And so let's say you want better quality rest. You know, you can think, you know, make a smiley face with Z's coming out of it or something like that. So in terms of your goals, take a look at what you wrote and make another little index card or post it and have that somewhere where you see it, you know, on the fridge or the bathroom mirror, just to remind you of what's your current project right now. So again, I want to thank you so much for joining me, and you can find me on Facebook, either in the My Post-Traumatic Growth Facebook group or Post-Traumatic Growth page. And you can also find me on Twitter at Breathe, on YouTube. You can find me at Andreka Cochliat. And my stamp, My Post-Traumatic Growth. So I'm going to be hosting another functional forum at the public library. You can find me also on Eventbrite. Let's see if I have that. So this is my Eventbrite page, and so Eventbrite is an events manager, and here I am on YouTube, Andreka Cochliat, and Post Traumatic Growth on Facebook, and there you go. So thank you so much for watching, precious souls, and just hoping that we all are blessed by wonderful things, and I look forward to sharing again next month. Bye-bye. Hi friends, welcome, and thank you for joining me for my happiness fitness class. My name is Andreka, and I am here to give some ideas on the latest about happiness training.
And you can find me, I'm a house healing place coach and lifestyle ally,
and I am on YouTube under Andreka Cochliat, Facebook, and I have a Facebook group, Post Traumatic Growth, and Facebook page, My Post Traumatic Growth,
and I'm also on
YSTEM
through My Post Traumatic Growth, and Eventbrite, you can find me, Andreka Cochliat, there, and
in Gmail. And so what I'm doing here is I'm focusing on happiness, wellness, happiness, fitness. I recently completed a class, and I'd like to share the foundation with you. And what I'm talking about is reality architecture, and I'm looking at the human being as real estate. Like, we are our most valuable real estate. Our land, our car, you know, like what we, if our own real estate is not doing well, then everything is affected by by that. And of course, the most valuable real estate is the 4 inches between our ears. So I am working on helping people with their reality architecture. So people have architecture for building their house or building a building, but we can have architecture of our mind, of our reality.
And so I focus on
lifestyle design. And so just getting straight to it, what's your goal? Like, what's your priority right now? Just off the top of your head, what is it that you want to bring more to you? And just as we're getting started, it's good to have a pen and paper. And I really mean, like, have a journal or a little notepad. Your ability to achieve goals increases like 90% when we actually write things down on a piece of paper. Even though we can type things into our devices, writing is much more powerful. It has an anchoring effect. It uses like thousands of parts of our whole system. So write down just the first thing that comes to your mind. What is it that you want to bring more to you? And just think about how it makes you feel in your body. And if you can just attribute like a symbol, you know, a little heart or a smiley face or sunshine or whatever. And put a little symbol with that note of what it is that you want, just the first impression goal that you want to have more in your life right now. I know, like, where did that come from? Bear with me. So what am I doing? I am a content curator. I have gathered information for a company, I work for a public utility company in California. And what I did was I read several, like 20 newspapers, online databases, and websites, and gathered data about each week about the public utility industry. And so, even before that, I was gathering information and archiving information, and since then, I continue to do so, and my focus is more about post-traumatic growth and autoimmune wellness. And so the people that I work with are folks who are dealing with overwhelm. They're not getting enough rest at night. They can't fall asleep or stay asleep. They still feel exhausted in the morning. They've got a to-do list a mile long, and their health could be better. And for some people, like, one's superpower is just showing up. And that matters. Just keeping on showing up, keeping on starting, that is a superpower. And a little bit more about me, my clients, and people who have taken workshops. I was at the Employment Development Department in California, and I hosted workshops about resume writing, public speaking, and brainstorming
for jobs. And so people told me that I gave them one of the best classes, I made a big difference, I was inspiring, excellent instructor, outstanding and supportive. And since then, so I was at Experience Unlimited, which was sponsored by the Employment Development Department. I gave workshops through the Life Plan Center. I have a certification in feng shui, in iridology. I have training in aura, chakra, past life readings. And I was one of the first 200 people in Chris Kresser's ADAPT Academy, his beta test for the ADAPT Academy. And currently I'm hosting the functional forum at the public library once a month. And it's run by the Evolution of Medicine, so you can find me there. And what this is about is happiness, fitness, and the value of the advantages you have
with a happiness fitness gym,
so to speak. And
so the goal of this is to provide easy, reliable results
fast, and to be solution oriented, realistic, and
replace people pleasing, replace just like keeping your head down instead with representing your own interests. And your own interests are, again, that you are your own real estate. What's in your head is your own real estate, and it matters.
And this quote by John Leech, denial and activity prepare people well for the roles of victim in courts.
So denial and inactivity prepare people well for the roles of victim in courts. And so it just in my experience, there are people who are just letting other people they're being forced to do things. And so what I'm encouraging people is you get to have boundaries, you get to speak up, you get to have your own preferences. And of course, we can't always get what we want, but
we can try.
And so in terms of like a happiness fitness class, one of the things that I like
on this list is it talks about
exercises. And of course, we know exercise for people who have all of their health and well-being. You know, like people love to go jogging or doing marathons or do sports. And the people that I am interacting with have post-traumatic stress disorder and autoimmune issues as a result of that post-traumatic stress disorder. And so when you have autoimmune issues, you can have reduced energy levels. And what I find helpful in terms of movement practices are something that may seem minor. So one of the things that you may have heard is if we adjust our posture or even change our expression, that changes the chemistry, our hormones. So in my first video, I was talking about if you get a chopstick, or you know, if you just force yourself to smile and like think of like a funny video or funny comedian, allow yourself to smile. And smiling, like, if you can do it, and so I would encourage you to try to do it for like 3 minutes, or not 3 minutes, 3 seconds. And so with people who have resistance to happiness, there's a learned helplessness. And with that learned helplessness is a sense of powerlessness. And so you may be resistant to well-meaning people who make these suggestions because it seems like it's this never-ending, exhausting process. So that's why I'm saying try this for 3 minutes. So, or not 3 minutes, 3 seconds. So if you can, smile for 3 seconds, right, and see if you notice the difference in your body. Amy Cuddy did a TED talk about body postures, and she tested hormone levels of people who are doing body postures, and she recommends for intimidating situations to actually do it's almost like yoga for confidence. So she recommends people go to the bathroom and, you know, go in the stall and do these exercises. So you can do like the smiling for 3 seconds. And so when you think of somebody who has won a contest or who has won a race, what is it that they do? Like what would, like in the privacy of your own home as you're sitting there, like they do this, right? They're like, I'm a winner. And so Amy Cuddy has done hormone testing on people who are doing that, and it their positive hormones increase when we do that body posture.
And so that's one of the movement practices that I like.
And in terms of like a movement practice, do what's doable for you rather than comparing yourself to other people. And so the first on this list is, like she writes, pleasure, and I would actually call that a parasympathetic response. So we have an autonomic nervous system that's made up of the parasympathetic stress response and the sympathetic stress response system. And so parasympathetic has to do with rest and digest. And with resting and proper digestion comes detox and repair. Because when we're kind of, when our cells are resting, when they're able to function, we just, like, our body kind of cleans itself out. When we're in the sympathetic stress response, we are on high alert. Just imagine the siren is going off and the red lights are flashing. So when you're on high alert all the time, do you think that your body is resting? When you're on high alert all the time, is your body digesting? Is your body detoxing when you're on high alert all the time? No, right? So it's, and all the research that I have done as of late, it seems like activating that parasympathetic stress response is the foundation to healing. And in one of my previous videos, I talk about Cody Lundeen, who's an outdoor survival teacher who wrote When All Hell Breaks Loose. The most important thing above like food, clothing, shelter is positive attitude. That's the foundation for survival. We have to have a positive attitude in order to survive. So that links up with this parasympathetic response. We have to be able to rest and digest and detox in order to survive. If we're on red alert, we're on high alert all the time, that's leading to chronic illness and early artificial death. Honestly, I mean that's the proof. Because when I was a kid, people did not have diabetes, they did not have cancer to the degree they do now, did not have autism. Like, it is just this phenomenon, and it's like I'm almost 50, and so 40 years ago, I did like things, and I lived in a major city, so there's a lot of different people, and people were not as sick 40 years ago as they are now. And 40 years ago, they didn't, like, the EPA wasn't on the ball about toxins and stuff. There was all sorts of stuff being put in the air. So it just seems like there's, it's important for us to take a look at what we can manage to maintain our real estate, to maintain our estate. And our estate is our body and our mind. And like I was saying before, is that parasympathetic response, that rest and digest response is the foundation. Like that has to be numero uno. And then we add the food and the whatever. So to boost the parasympathetic response is being in nature, getting fresh air, getting safe exposure to sunlight. So we need our vitamin D, but with chemtrails in the sky, that is creating like the UVC, and that's coming out more and more even in conventional disclosure. So we need to be in nature and just maybe be careful, at high noon, maybe have some light long sleeves on, if that's what you happen to be outside. And also, so we want to have healthy amount of daylight, and then as dawn or as dusk progresses, we also want to have lights out. We want to start turning the lights out. One of the problems with modern inventions is that we can have lights on 24 hours, and people have chronic illness that are exposed to light all the time. There was a study done where the fact that somebody's leg was exposed to light as they slept and their blood sugar was affected. So your insulin and your blood sugar is affected by the lights that are on in your bedroom when you're thinking you're asleep. Like, if you have lights on your skin or that's triggering your awareness when you're sleeping, even though your consciousness may seem to be out, your biology is still being triggered by light. So it is ideal to start turning down lights in the late afternoon, in the early evening, and there's those new Thomas Edison, those old fashioned bulbs. I know they're like $20 or something, but that's like, that has like the wattage of a candlelight, like the new LED lights, and those fluorescent lights are really not so great for us, particularly that blue light. It's just, so the fluorescent lights, they have mercury vapors. Those LED lights have the blue light, which is just really hard on the body. So I would recommend getting the good old fashioned incandescent lights and go for low wattages and start turning out lights at night. When you're going to sleep, have a night, a lights out situation, so you're not getting ambient light from street lamps, street lights outside, or cars sweeping your room with their headlights if your bedroom is at a road.
So adjusting lights.
Making sure that your water, the water that you drink is as purified as you can do, as you can make it. And if you can have your bathing water be have a purifier. And also,
I would just make sure that, you know, in terms of like food,
so some people, so, and I understand like there's like economic limitations in terms of getting water filters. And what I would just say is do what you can. And so in terms of food, I can't buy organic. So what I do is I look up, there's like the, there's different lists. There's the Dirty Dozen and there's the Clean 15. And I would just buy, if I'm buying conventionally, like I'm doing, I buy the Clean 15, the list of fruits and vegetables there. With the Dirty Dozen, like celery is one of the ones that gets a lot of pesticides with conventional growers. So I do buy organic celery all the time, and I try to buy organic parsley or whatever.
And
this list, she's also saying fasting. And for the people that I'm working with who have post-traumatic stress disorder and autoimmune issues, fasting can be another trigger. And so what I would just take that as is just fasting from a stressful mentality. And so just choosing to do the parasympathetic rest, digest, like detox lifestyle. Like if we're getting enough rest, if we're taking naps when we need to, if we're taking a break, we're setting boundaries, like saying what you really need to have happen even though somebody's bullying you. Like that's kind of a fast from doing things the way I've always done it. It's a fast from learned helplessness. Learned helplessness can be just like a comfortable space.
And so in terms of So I talked a little bit about movement practice, and so in her list, this list from Thrive, she's talking about avoiding procrastination, saying, I'll start tomorrow. And what I would do is, instead of calling it procrastination, or, you know, stop saying, I'll start tomorrow, is look at what you are doing right now. It's important to endorse yourself for what you're doing right now, and also it's important to recognize what is going right. Like, you know, God's green earth is so beautiful, and that's going right. And in refraining from saying, and the sky is falling because, you know, there's all these toxins in the air. Like, try to give credit to the creator. Trusting that some things are bigger than we could possibly imagine. And so I just also just keep giving yourself credit, like you're watching this video, so endorse yourself for that.
And emotions,
so I was talking about that. That's basically what I was talking about in terms of the parasympathetic stress response, that Cody Lundeen is saying that for the foundation of survival is a positive attitude. And I'm going to extrapolate, a positive attitude is activating our parasympathetic system and activating the rest, digest, detox. And because like sometimes it's annoying to be like, oh, I gotta be positive. Maybe we can't think positive thoughts, but working on your resting, working on better digesting, working on like allowing your body to detox, allowing your body to relax enough to like let go of toxins, that is what I'm calling even kind of more than the everything, the rainbows and
butterflies kind of thing about positive attitude. So she talks about testing here. I'm gonna pass over that, and symptoms and supplements. And so we're talking about,
we talked about detox. So I would just say,
so I just like that list. Those are just like some
good ideas. And so back to the journal and the quiz. So as I was saying, we are our own real estate. We're our most valuable estate. And of course, what's in our head is like the gem of our estate. And so in terms of well-being or whatever your goal may be that inspired you to watch this video, think about what it is that you want to bring more to your life. So thinking about what we've just discussed here, it can be the same thing as when we first started this. It could be something different. So just go with your first impression. Of course, you can always change that in the future. And I want you to think, maybe consider a symbol. What could be a little logo? First thing that comes to your mind of what it is that you want to bring from what you just learned today. So do you want more confidence, more sense of accomplishment? Do you want to make better choices or take a new class or get a new something or other? So draw like a little symbol of what that might be. You know, maybe it's getting a car or getting a diploma or whatever. And you can just write a little note of what that symbol means to you. And so we're just working off of anchoring that goal. And you want to put this somewhere where you see it on a regular basis. So that's like going to be your kind of project for right now. And so I want to thank you so much for joining me, for
participating in this class with your presence, participating in the show as an audience. And of course, you can find me.
I'm hosting events at the library through Eventbrite. So you can find me at my productivity gym class on Eventbrite. And it's just spelled how it sounds. You can find me at Andreka Cochliat on YouTube, and you can get the spelling from Eventbrite. You can also find me on Facebook. Post-traumatic growth is the page, and then my post-traumatic growth is the group. And also I am on Twitter as well, and it's really deep. So you'll just see the same logo there. So again, thank you so much for watching, and blessings to you and your loved ones and all of us. And I look forward to the next show I do next month. And feel free to find me on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube, and or join me at the library for the next functional forum. And send me your email so I can keep you posted as to my next functional forums, my next show here on MCAT. And ideally, I'd love to have a live audience. And so thank you for watching.